ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोर्श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरोर्नवैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामये। नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। जयतां सुरतो पंगो मम मंदमतिर्गति मत्सर्वस्य पदाम्भोजौ राधा मदन मोहनौ दिव्यवृंदारण्यकल्पद्रुमादः श्रीमद्रत्नागारसिंहासनस्थो श्रीमद्राधाशीलगोविंददेवो प्रेष्ठालिभिः सेव्यमानो स्मरामि। श्रीमान् रासरसारम्भे वंशी वटतटस्थितः कर्षन् वेणुस्वनैर्गोपी गोपीनाथश्रियेस्तु नः। तप्तकाञ्चनगौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायिते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषये नमः। पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकम्। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। Hare Krishna. Welcome to the day of hearing Srimad Bhagavat Katha Shatakam. This is being arranged and is being continued by Bhaktivedanta College of Vedic Education, Navi Mumbai, Maharashtra, India. So for last 25 days we have been hearing the uninterrupted and blissful Krishna Katha. The entire Srimad Bhagavatam. Now we have reached Dashama Skanda, 10th canto. Already we are, yesterday we enjoyed the spiritual bliss of attending the 16,108 marriages of Krishna in Dwaraka by our glorification, by our kirtan and hearing. And today we have entered into 26th. Day of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, and in next 4 days we will be coming to the Purnahuti. That is actually it is not 30th, it is 30 and 31st. After 30 days we will be doing the Purnahuti on the 31st day. That is the 6th May, which is the Narsingha Chaturdashi. So Narsingha Chaturdashi day we will have a special hearing of Lord Narsingha's pastimes of killing Hiranyakashipu and establishing Prahlad Maharaj and awarding him, forcing him to take great enjoyment, 36,000 years of ruling, and also enjoying all the material comforts. And also we'll be hearing the unlimited pastimes and supreme power of Krishna. Also we'll be hearing on that day as a concluding remark. So we will be in this way. We'll keep the blissful situation and blissful condition continuously. And this is the in this way we actually got connected to the drinking or relishing the Srimad Bhagavatam on a continuous basis. So before getting to story, today's stories, let us start our with prayers. A standard prayers. Narayanam namaskritya नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तमा श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। सो बाय प्रेइंग by offering our obeisances to Lord Narayana, who are residing at Badrikashrama, for awarding blessings on all the people who wanted to really take up the austerity, and also offering our obeisances to Srila Vyasadeva, who compiled the Srimad Bhagavatam, and also offering obeisances to the mother of learning, that is Saraswati Ma. We will be starting Bhagavatam as discussed many times, and by offering prayers to them only we will become successful in Srimad Bhagavatam hearing. And Srimad Bhagavatam hearing purpose is very clear: to attain the love of Godhead, prema pumartho mahan. So our interest is love. So here in Srimad Bhagavatam it is clearly mentioned at the end by Suta Goswami that the human beings take up various activities like following Varnashrama Dharma, and also they take up so many austerities, they take up the charities and many such activities, and also they take up the Veda Shravana, the hearing of Vedas also they take up, and they all lead to getting the unlimited opulence. They all lead to unlimited opulence. However, but if somebody takes up the beautiful glorification of Lakshmipati, that is Supreme Personality of Godhead, and also hearing very sincerely about the glorification, and also accepting the process, they will be bestowed with a uninterrupted attachment to Supreme Lord Krishna. That is called Avismuti Sridhara Pada Padmayor. So if somebody accept the glorification, and somebody accepts to hear to Srimad Bhagavatam, and also they make the point, yes, this hearing Bhagavatam is very, very good and very, very authentic. If somebody openly declare it, the result is that they will get undeterred attachment to the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. And they will be able to avismrutim. Avismrutim means they will never forget. They will never forget lotus feet of. It is mentioned Bhagavatam, avismrutim sridhara pada padmayor gunanuvada shravanadaradibhi. If somebody means they will get attached, they will get attachment, means they will never forget. So somebody must, okay, if I don't forget Krishna's lotus feet, then what is the result? Okay, you said that by Srimad Bhagavatam glorification or hearing or accepting or endorsing, you will never forget the lotus feet of Krishna. That is good. But what is the result of that? When it is mentioned that if you are attached to hearing of Srimad, if you are attached to remembering Krishna's lotus feet continuously, the next result is avisputi Krishna padaravindayo shunyoti abhadrani chasham tanoti. This is the message. What is that is, if somebody is having not having any forgetfulness about the lotus feet of Krishna. Smriti means remembering. Vismriti is forgetting. And avismriti, it means never forgetting. So like the first is positive, negative, again one more. Smriti is remembering. Vismriti, when you added vismriti means forgetfulness. Avismriti means never forgetting. So the biggest problem in this material world is we forget Krishna. because we have forgotten the material, the spiritual world, and came to Krishna. That's why forgetfulness is very, very common. Remembering is not common, but forgetfulness is very common. So what all we require is we want to be freed from forgetfulness. That's why the word is used avismruti. There are two times used avismruti. Avismruti Krishna Padaravindayo Shinyo Chabadrani Cha Sham Tanoti. So by forgetting, by never forgetting Krishna's lotus feet, the first step is Shinyosti Abhadrani. All the Abhadras. So for example, the present Abhadra is pandemic all over the world. So such is Kshinoti, so they will get destroyed. So when constantly, because this is not spiritual world. The spiritual world is each and every person. Each and every person is connected to Krishna. Whereas in material world, you may be connected to Krishna, or you may not be even 24 hours connected to Krishna. You may be doing various activities, sir. But apart from you, there are millions and those who are totally forgotten Krishna. So this has been created. This has been created in such a way that constantly something or other will be happening. Then what is the solution? Solution is that Kshinoti Abhadrani. So whatever Abhadra they come, they will be destroyed slowly by what? Avismruti Krishna Padaravindayo. So by taking Srimad Bhagavatam process, you will get be blessed with a boon that you will never have forgetfulness. You will never have forgetfulness for Krishna's lotus feet. And the result of that is that whenever any Abhadrani comes, that Kshinoti, they get destroyed. Because at that time, you remember more vigorously. And next is Cha Sham Tanoti. Sham means great fortune. Tanoti means and it awards. So it not only destroys the Abhadrani and it also awards a great fortune. So I am sure that after post-corona, all our devotion, all our attachment, all our seriousness will be much multiples of that. Multiples depends on the each one individual. It could be double, it could be triple, it could be 100 times. It could be 1,000 times, we don't know that depending on seriousness, but at least it will not be same. It will be at least multiple. It could be double, it could be triple. So, this is the effect of remembering Krishna. Sham Tanoti. Sham means great fortune. Then, this is at the material platform, this is immediate effect, but unforgetfulness means not forgetting. Actually awards much higher also. What is that is Sattvasya Suddhim Paramatma Bhaktim. The Bhagavatam is saying that next it okay it awards you it removes the Abhadra, it awards removes Abhadra and awards the great fortune, but also Sattvasya Suddhim. It actually it purifies the heart. And Paramatma Bhaktim, it gives devotion towards the Paramatma. Somebody may get confused, especially all the ISKCON devotees. Why suddenly Paramatma? Paramatma is for yogis. Then Krishna's constant remembering, why it gives Paramatma Bhakti? So it is a very top secret. It cannot be discussed at length. But the fact that it is mentioned, Sattvasya Suddhim Paramatma Bhakti. These are the further results of Krishna's remembering, means Avismruti Krishna Padaravinda. When we are not forgetting Krishna's lotus feet, it results in Paramatma Bhakti. Paramatma Bhakti, Krishna talks about in Uddhava Gita, very detailed. He said that, please see, what is the final, he gives the, what is the Bhakti Yoga Sara? Bhakti Yoga Sara is, please identify me, look at me, means have my darshan in everybody's heart as Paramatma. It's called Paramatma. Whenever we see any person, any reason, we see that a person, suddenly when we see its name, his form, his body, his qualities, like that, it all things, they come to our mind. But Krishna says that if you come to the stage that whenever you see any bird or beast or sthavara or jangama, anything, if you are able to see Paramatma in that side, then you are becoming eligible to come to my place. Because you will be stuck in this world because you are not seeing the super soul, you are seeing the body, you are seeing their mind, you are seeing their characteristics, you are seeing their different qualities. So they are in the trigunas, and you are also looking at their trigunas. But Krishna within their body is beyond trigunas. So when you start looking beyond the triguna, the great personality is Krishna, that is called Paramatma Bhakti. Krishna advised Uddhava that if you look me as Paramatma in every body, in every sthavara jangama, that is the final one that you develop. And Krishna says that to the extent, to develop that, in the beginning, even if you are required to pay prostrate obeisances, dandavat pranam to a donkey, is also to do it. All your friends or relatives may laugh at you, but you go, do dandavat pranam even to dog. You do dandavat pranam to your donkey. So in that way, you are seeing the, you are not looking at the donkey. You are not looking at the horrible creature. You are trying to see the superstar. When you develop that, then you will come. Seeing that means you are not bound, because the living entities are bound by trigunas, and you are not looking at trigunas, you are going beyond trigunas and seeing this supreme personality, me, in the form of Paramatma. It's called Paramatma Bhakti. So it's a very, very deep subject matter. It's not, it's only in the initial you have to take into the ear, then contemplate, meditate, seek blessings of the senior Vaishnavas. What does it mean? When Krishna told this, what does it mean? That when I am constantly remembering and without forgetfulness, I am cutting complete avismrutim Krishna, his lotus feet. He said that I am going to get Paramatma Bhakti. What does it mean? So, but the Bhagavatam message is that. So, with this great message, we'll get onto our, because this is some sort of a teaser or a great, because Krishna, after telling entire Uddhava Gita, Uddhava says, it's becoming very difficult for me to understand. Please tell me the final one. Because he gives so much yoga, Sankhya. Finally, Uddhava says that it is becoming very difficult. Tell me the final. Then he tells the Paramatma. So, when you really get into the Srimad Bhagavatam studying, when you get into study of Srimad Bhagavatam, and you have urge, when you have urge that you want to understand it, you want to get revealed about the great secret, then it will be revealed. And then you will enter into a spiritual bliss, and that is the situation of Triguna Theta Sthiti. You are free from the Sattva, Raja, Tamaguna. You are away from that, and that is the place you become eligible to have a spiritual bliss here, and also get transferred to the spiritual world, to Krishna. So with this introduction, we'll start today's stories. Today also we'll hear four stories very happily, as you all enjoyed, as all of us enjoyed the four nice stories. Today also we'll enjoy. So the first story is the story of happiness and story of wonder, that is story of victory of Baladev. The extraordinary power of Baladev is our first story. And there we heard Pat Shukadev Goswami also talk very elaborately at the end. And we need to really repeatedly hear the pastimes of Baladev, because Baladeva is the original spiritual master. Because of that, unless we develop a strong attachment to Baladev. So mind you that when Gargamuni came, he gave three names to the Rohini Suta. I am Hirohino Putra. So he has given three names. What is that? First name is Rama. So the name first name given to Rohini's son is Rama. He said that this son of Rohini is going to give pleasure to all his friends and relatives. So, and that's why his name is given Rama. So if you don't have friendship, relationship with Balram, so how can you get pleasure? His name is, okay, he is a big king, but if you don't have any link with king, what the king is going to give gift? He can't going to give any gift because you don't have any relation with king. So king may be having hundreds and thousands of villages or towns under his control, but why he will give you? Because you are no way connected to that king. So similarly, Rohini's son's name is, he has put Rama. Rama is, he said, okay, because he's going to give pleasure to all his friends and relatives. So did we establish the relation with Balram? If you're not established, then take for granted that no pleasure. This is special. And he said that, okay, Rama is very, very powerful, very, very strong. He performs so many great activities. That's why his name is Baladev. So, are we made any good relation with him? So that at any given point of time when required, we request, oh, by Baladev, please, you are very powerful, do something. So, just imagine. So, fortunately, Srila Prabhupada has introduced Krishna Balaram's worship and Krishna Balaram's love into our movement, and that's why we see a beautiful place in Vrindavan which is dedicated to Krishna Balaram. So people should know that they should have attachment to the Baladev and Balaram, then they will be flooded with love and also flooded with protection because of his power. That's why we need to understand his love and also we need to understand its power. So now we are going to hear his unlimited love and unlimited power once again, so that we can remember and try to make an attempt to establish relation with Balaram, Baladev. So when Krishna and Balaram came, because we have to understand one point, that even in the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, Shaunakadi rishis were asking very, very, very specifically, Krutavakila karmani saharamena keshava ati martyani bhagavan goda kapatama. They were asking very specific question. What Supreme Lord Krishna performed in activities with the help of Krutavakila karmani saharamena, with the association of Lord Balaram. And also when Sutta Goswami is mentioning about the incarnation, ekona vimshe vimshati me vrishnisho prape janmani Rama Krishna iti bhuvo Bhagavan Haradbal. So these actually Supreme Lord. So why repeatedly is coming? It is our fortune. It is not our duty. I cannot say use the duty. It is our fortune that if you make relationship with Krishna and Balaram. So first should be with Balaram because he is the original spiritual master. So when Krishna and Balaram came to Mathura from Vrindavan, they went to Dwaraka. We have heard they all now married, they got their children also married, the third generation also came into picture, and daughters, granddaughters, their marriages, big, many years passed. And Krishna made so many attempts. Krishna made so many attempts to go to Vrindavan because he has promised many times that in the beginning also. But he could not go because all the Yadavas are very much worried. Very much worried because they know very well that the love that they express, that demonstrate, is beyond anybody's comprehension. The love shown by gopis is beyond anybody's imagination. That is, Mathura Rasa is beyond anybody's imagination. If Krishna again tastes it, he will never come back to Dwaraka. No chance of Krishna coming back to Dwaraka. And if he again tastes the Vatsala Rasa by Nanda Yashoda, there is no chance that he will come back to Dwaraka. and he be Sudama and Soka Krishna as the friends, relations, and he will never come back to it. That's why when he planned, they used to tell something and somehow the program is cancelled, so program is postponed, like that several years passed. One day Balram said, no, nothing doing, I am going. He broke all the logics and obstacles and he went straight. So this Krishna also felt, okay, at least you go, I could not break all these things. So Balram went there, and his sole interest is to show love, pleasure to all friends, because his name is given Rama, because his name itself says that he gives pleasure to all the friends and relatives. So he went alone. He went alone to Vrindavan, and first he went and paid obeisances to Nanda Baba and Yashoda Maya, and when they also loved him, they first expressed their love and also said, you and your son, your brother should always be protecting us. This is what we want, and we want all of you to remember us, and we want to be protected by you. This way they mentioned both Nanda Baba and Yashoda Maya, and took him onto their lap. Balram is almost like a grandfather, but they took him onto their lap, and they started embracing him and crying so much, so that the Balrama's body is completely got wet because of the tears. And everybody came and they sat around Balram and started asking the whole about the Yadavas and Dwaraka, and they started remembering that because of Krishna and Balaram only they all came out of the Kamsa's great terror. And while they were talking like this, all gopis came, and they started asking about Krishna. So their always point is that Krishna is always very attractive for the women, the girls and women. And they said that, okay, so far he used to be attracted, he would be always used to attract all the cowherd people, cowherd girls and women. But how is he? Because now he is attracting the Purastri. Purastri means those who are the women. So the darling of women of the town, is he okay? Is he happy? And does he remember our activities? Like that they ask him. And by the speaking itself, when they are, sometimes we speak about our concern, love. So while speaking, we burst into tears. So when all gopis, when they are talking, they burst into tears. And Balram consoled them and gave the message of Krishna, and everybody became cool. And Balram stayed for 2 months. He stayed for 2 months in the Braj, and he demonstrated that he is the real pleasure giving to all his people who consider him as near and dear. So because of that, he gave to the entire Brajavasis, and whatever the agony they faced, they really experienced for several years, they all forgot and they became very happy. So one night Balram went to the Vrindavan forest along with gopis, and Acharya said these gopis are different than the gopis who played with Krishna. Even Balram also played rasa dance, but those who deny this or don't accept the rasa dance by Balram, so they are not authentic people. But there's a big difference between Krishna's rasa dance and this one, because there Krishna is yoga. He has expanded into thousands and thousand forms, and here also here is not such thing. So when Balram went, he was alone with other gopis, but they are not in thousands. At that time, Varuna, the king Varuna, not king, the demigod Varuna, he made ambrosia, Varuni, to flow from a tree. And because of that, the entire forest became so much, that Varuni was flowing, like as if it is flowing from a pot, like a pot is flowing. So from the tree it started flowing out. And it was so fragrant, and that fragrance really spread all over the forest. And when the fragrance came, Balram got attracted. That's why Balram, we see that during Balram birthday, Balram appearance day, people offer honey, because Balram is always interested in the honey. So here it is similar to that, but at the time that is a Devaloka honey, not a material honey. So then Balram went and nicely relished that honey. It is called Varuni. And even gopis also drank that honey, and everybody got nicely intoxicated. They're feeling very, very happy, very, very light. And when they were moving and dancing, all the demigods showered flowers. Then he, Balram, thought, okay, let me also have a nice jalakrida. Let's have a water sporting. So then he immediately asked Yamuna to come closer. But Yamuna felt that, oh, he appears to be intoxicated, so it's not so good to go closer to him. And Baldeva's intoxication is not material, it is not a materialistic intoxication. It is actually originally given by Varuna Deva, and it is his pastime. And when Baladeva felt that the Yamuna is not accepting the order of him, then he became very furious, and he got ready to tear it off the entire Yamuna into hundreds and thousands. So when you tear it off, then the existence itself get diminished or get lost. When he started pulling the Yamuna with his plow, then Yamuna became very fearful and came in front and asked for the excuse. And then Balram took bath, the Jalakrida. When he came out, Kanti Devi and came in front of him and gave him a blue clothes and the most invaluable ornaments. That's why we see always Baladev is wearing blue dress. Krishna wear always yellow dress, and Balram is wearing blue dress. So it is very, very specific. So even now also we can see that where the Baladev has demonstrated his anger on the Yamuna, and it's called Ramaghat. And it's Jaya Ramaghata Jaya Rohini Nandan. So the song also there. So Rohini Nandan Balram, so where he has shown his power is called Ramghat, where Balram along with gopis he took bath, or he took not bath, he took he sported water sports in Yamuna. And in this way we can see the power of Baladev, at the same time love of Balram. So when we talk about love or pleasure, we say call him as Ram, but we want to show his power because Bala. So Baladev and Balaram. So we can, there is another also to show the power of Balaram, Baladev. There was a very powerful monkey by name Dvivida. Dvivida is a monkey, and this monkey demon is a monkey, but he has become a demonic. And originally he is from even Treta Yuga. He is the associate of Lord Rama. He was working in the Ram Ravana Sangram. He was part of the Vana Sena. Dvivida, so powerful, very, very powerful, one of the monkeys. But he made some offense. He made offense towards Lakshmana. Because of making some offense to Lakshmana, he got a bad association. Bad association. So he was continuing from the Treta Yuga, he continued even like Bhalluka, that Jambavan was continuing from Treta Yuga to Dwapara Yuga, and he fought with Krishna and finally gave his daughter Jambavati to Krishna. So like that, there is another Vanara named Vivida, very powerful. He continued his life till the Dwapara Yuga. But because he made an offense with Lakshmana, he became friend of Narakasura. You just imagine, by because of making offense with Supreme Lord, he got a bad associate in the next when he continued. But because but if you look at the great Jambavan, so from beginning he is very connected to Lord Rama. So since he did not made any bad association or made any offense, he again, but he prayed for a fight, duel with Supreme Lord. That's why Lord has granted him to 28 days fight. That is the desire only, but it was never because of the offense. Whereas this Dvivida, because of the offense at Lakshmana in Dwapara Yuga, he became friend of Narakasura. And because of this Narakasura's Sangatya, his mind became totally polluted. Just imagine, if you associate with a devotee, you will become devoted. If you make association with karmis or association with materialistic people, your thoughts will be always materialistic. So, because of the association of Narakasura, he also developed a demonic nature. And when Narakasura was killed by Krishna, Dvivida became very furious. He said, I'll go and fight and take revenge on Krishna. You just imagine. Once earlier, he was in the association of Rama in the Vanara Sena, and because of bad association, he wanted to take revenge on Krishna. So that is the bad effect of that. Then he became with that mood of taking revenge on Krishna. He started coming towards Dwarka. So then whatever the villages, towns, whichever is there, and he started destroying continuously. He went into the hermitages and he used to go and spoil the hermitages and also spoil the yajna vatika, and used to destroy the yajna kundas and used to spoil it, and used to pass urine in the yajna kundas. In that way, he made a big catastrophe everywhere, and he used to take women and men, and used to just make them captured in a cave, and used to put the big stone so that they would not come out. In this way, and even he used to jump into the ocean. He used to jump in ocean and push water onto the shore so much, so that it like a tsunami used to happen, that all by nearing on this shore used to get washed out. He was so much powerful. Just to give an imagination, he is going into the ocean and pushing water to create a tsunami. That was the powerful. So then in that way, the Dvivida started moving, and he came to a place called Raivataka. Raivataka hill, Parvata. So he started moving. He was planning to go to Krishna, to Dwaraka, but he came to Raivataka. There he saw some nice music coming. Nice, somebody is singing. Then suddenly, who is this singing? He went and saw there the Balaram, Baladev was there. So Baladev was moving with the gopis, and he has taken the Varani and nicely singing. He was attracted. Oh, it's very very beautiful and nicely singing, and he appears to be intoxicated, and he went near to Baladev and started making mischief like a monkey. So monkey is always when people see monkey, they started showing monkey activities. When monkey also does same thing, so it is mutually equal activities. So when he started making some peculiar sounds, the Dvivida started peculiar sounds, and also insulting the ladies, and also started pulling the ladies' garments. So anybody would do, say, if monkey comes, anybody would do what? They take a stone and throw it. So similarly, Baladeva also took a stone and just put it, thrown onto this. But that fellow just escaped it and came, jumped and took away the Varuni Patra. Varuni Patra from Baladeva. And also he started pulling the dresses of the ladies. Then Baladeva felt that, oh, I think he is not a ordinary monkey. He has to be seriously dead. And he immediately invited his musala, that is a plow and a club. Plow and a club. And he immediately he hit him on his head. With one hit itself, his skull got cracked. He did not break into that, but he got a crack and he started blood coming out. But the Dvivedha did not stop there. And he immediately jumped onto a tree and he just uprooted the tree and started attacking them. But when he was attacked, and he has thrown that, but Baladeva immediately cut that tree into the 100 pieces. And then at that time, the Dvivedha thought, let him go and punch on the chest of Baladev. But at the time, the Baladev hit him on his neck in such a way that he just fell it. He fell down and his mouth. And that Dvivedha, when he fell, the Raivataka Parvata, almost it is shaken. He was so fiercely he fell, and he was such a big body, and the whole hill appeared shaken like an earthquake has happened. And when the Dvivedha was killed in that way, the Deva, Siddhagana, Munindra, they all said, Jai Jai Kar, Jai Jai Kar to Baladev, Jai Jai Kar to Baladev, everybody, Jai Jai Jai. They always sing Baladev, because they know it is not the activity of Balaram, it is Baladev. So all glories to Baladev, Namaskar, Namaskar. Namaha, Om Namo Namaha, Namo Namo. In that, they have started singing. That even Jai Jai Kar, they are singing the Vijay Geeti, the victory song. And Baladev took all the Jai Jai Kar of the great saintly persons, and he came back to his place. And we can see the Shukadeva Goswami also narrating another great activity, great prowess of Baladev. How he really threatened the entire Kauravas at one point of time to show his unlimited power. Krishna's son name is one of the sons' name is Samba. So we discussed about him. This Samba is a son of Jambavati. So we said that in one of the stories, always he was having some lenience or some sort of, even if somebody is making some mistake, especially of Jambavati's children, he never took it very serious. So we'll see that even the Yaduvamsha got cursed because of this this boy, Samba. So he's always used to be very naughty, and used to be always creating some sort of trouble. Of course, he's a very powerful boy, but going extra mile. What he did is, Duryodhana had one daughter by name Lakshman. So Duryodhana is having one son also, Lakshmana Kumara, and also the daughter Lakshmana. So Duryodhana, when she became yukta vayasya, when it was suitable age for marriage, so Duryodhana arranged for a swayamvar that she can choose her choice. So she is very beautiful and very nice girl also. And Rajkumar, they came. to that Swayamvar. And Krishna's son, Samba, also went to that son, went to the Swayamvar. He knows very well that Duryodhana is opposite to Krishna's devotees, but still he went there. Okay, that to that extent is fine. But in that Swayamvar, Lakshmana did not like him, did not choose him. So that is her choice, because Swayamvara means actually choosing. So she did not like him, but he liked her. So what he did, immediately he jumped like a Rakshasa Vidhi. He jumped and took her and went out. It just happened in 1 second. So when this happened, so they have no option, all the Kauravas, they had to really chase him, because that is against the wish and will of the girl. Of course, Rukmini case is different. Rukmini was willing to be taken, but here Lakshmana is not willing to go with Samba. So all the Kauravas, first of all, they went immediately to Bhishma Dev. Bhishma Dev, just you see this Yadava's boy, he did, and it is against the wish of the even girl. So we wanted to really go and punish him. He said, yes, yes, it is our responsibility to go and punish him, catch him, but mind one thing, that don't kill him. Because this boy already took her hand, so like Panigrahan is already over. So if you kill, she will become widow. So don't do that. But at the same time, we should not leave him. We have to punish him. So take care of this. So Bhishma Pitama has given proper guidance. We'll see how to handle it, but don't kill him, but catch him. So they all went, all the Kauravas, all the Dushtaja Dushtaya, and all went, with all army they went. And mind that the entire army is on one side and Samba is only one. He did not go with army. So the Yadu was like a lion. He fought very confidently, very boldly, and however, all people jointly attacked simultaneously, somehow destroyed his chariot, everything, and finally captured him and brought him to Hastinapur. So this message was taken by Narada Muni to Dwaraka, that okay, the Samba is captured by Kaurava and imprisoned. This message came, then immediately all the Yadavas, they became very furious and they jumped. Okay, let's go and make a fight with this all Kauravas and bring him back, our son. In that way, they all took the Astra Shastras. But at the time, Balaram said that, no, don't do that, because he feels he has always some good soft corner to Duryodhan. Why? Because Duryodhan did Sisharika, studentship. So he has learnt so many, especially Gada Yuddha, the fighting with club, he has learnt. He has learnt from Baladev. So he has a soft corner. He doesn't want to really make a fight between Yadavas and Kauravas. He was not very much. He said, there's no need, because Duryodhana is my student. I'll go and convince him and bring the boy back. Then Ugrasena, all the they said, okay, it's a good proposal. And Baladev went with many ministers and also Brahmanas and also Uddhavji. Because Uddhav is a good mediator, good messenger. So they all went, and they finally they reached Hastinapura, but they did not enter into Hastinapura. And they stayed outside Hastinapura in a big, nice Udyanavana, and sent a message by Uddhav that Baladev has come all the way from Dwaraka. When this message reached to Kauravas, all Kauravas, they came with so many Brahmanas with them, and all Brahmanas, they came along with Kauravas, and they worshipped and glorified Baladev and also offered the respects, everything, and all mangalakar, all auspicious items were given, the gifts are given, and in fact they made dandavat pranam to Baladeva. So in that way everything happened, and also asked exchange of nice questions about welfare. After happening, the Baladeva came to the point straight. He said that Ugrasena is our king, so we have to follow his instructions. So his order is that whatever you have done is not correct. The boy should be sent back to Dwaraka along with the girl. And by irreligion, by adharma you are captured, but still Yadavas we are pardoning, so please act immediately. So when this message is given by Baladev, suddenly, till then the all Kauravas was very humble, he suddenly became so rude, and immediately the people who were sitting down at his lotus feet, they all got up and started even abusing Baladev, and they started saying that it is just like the footwear is trying to reach to the position of the crown. Footwear position is at the feet, and the crown position is at the head. And now these Yadavas are trying to become, who are like a footwear, they are trying to reach to the head of us. So it is not at all acceptable. And actually we only have given them the kingdom, we only have given them all the Raja Lanchanas, everything, and now they have become so much proud. In that way, they, whatever they wanted to speak, they spoke in front of Baladev, on his face. Just imagine. The moment they went back, Baladev's anger was no bound. He said that these people's mother are the proud, reached to an extent that they can't hear. They can't hear any good words for them. Dandam dashagunam bhavet. Finally, we need to really punish them, and I will show what is the power of me, what is the strength of me. I'll show that. And they are feeling that the Supreme Lord Krishna, unto whom the all the various demigods and the all the universe demigods, they come and pay obeisances, that he is not eligible for the ruling. And is it that we are footwear and the Kauravas are the crown? So I'll teach them a great lesson today. He felt, he spoke in this way, and immediately went to Hastinapura, and with the idea that he wanted to really remove, like Krishna removed the Govardhana hill from the earth and took it up. So he wanted to really take the entire Hastinapura, remove it and take it and make it into pieces and put it into the Ganges. That was it. And he started with his plow, started lifting with his plow Hastinapura. So just imagine, suddenly if you are sitting on a chair, if somebody is trying to lift chair from back, you will find that some earthquake is taking place, you try to fall down. So each and everybody started, oh, what happened? The earthquake is happening. So he said, no, it is not earthquake, it is earth mover, the Baladev is lifting our entire Hastinapura. Then they came to, the Baladev is beyond anybody's control. They immediately ran towards Baladev and paid obeisance and asked for pardon. It says that your power we could not imagine, and please excuse us. We are foolish number one. We are foolish number one, and we are and also please excuse us. Please excuse us. And you came to protect the whole world. In that way, they started saying whatever they could say. And not only that, they started shivering, everybody shivering, because the Baladev was still lifting and trying to put, and they were crying because they are already on the tottering platform, on the moving, the earth is moving. Then they all again fell at the feet. Baladeva became cooled. Baladeva cooled. Everybody got all. And as Krishna put back the Govardhana hill, he also, Baladeva, allowed the entire Hastinapura settled down. And at that time, of course, he has given full confidence, don't worry, I will take care of, he mentioned. And Duryodhana came with his daughter, and Samba, and handed over to Baladeva. And not only he just handed over, he gave a lot of varakatna. So he has given 1200 elephants and 20,000 horses and 6,000 golden chariots, 10,000 servants, and everything he has given. Now Baladeva, with great opulence given by Duryodhana and his daughter, he came to Dwaraka. And when all people came to Dwaraka, everybody told what Baladeva performed. Everybody got stunned to see, wow, so great. Because they could see that he went and he brought both the son and daughter-in-law with so much varakat. And they are all very much pleased, And the prowess which is shown by Baladeva at that time is still can be seen in Hastinapura, Delhi. The southern part of Delhi is always appeared to be elevated, because already Baladeva has pushed his plough and lifted it. So then people are, the moment he has lifted, people started floating onto other side because of the, it has become a slant. So the Shukadeva Goswami said that now also we can see the southern part of the Delhi as Hastinapura is highly elevated, showing the inconceivable power of Baladeva. So in this way he glorified the Baladeva. He wanted to glorify him again and again, because he is the original spiritual master. And as we discussed in one of the stories, that because of him only, we are able to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. So we should remember this. We should always show gratitude. Because originally all the Puranas, for all Puranas, Romaharshana was made in charge by Vyasadeva. But since Romaharshana made an offense with Baladeva, he was killed. And at that time, by the order or by advice of all Rishi Munish in Naimisharanya, Baladeva gave a great strength to Romaharshana's son, his Suta Goswami. He has given a very long life, and perfect understanding of all Puranas. Because he was blessed, the Suta Goswami was blessed by Baladeva, he could again speak entire Bhagavatam. And because he was blessed, he became the Shrutidhara. And when he narrated, when Shukadeva Goswami was narrating Srimad Bhagavatam on the banks of Ganges, whatever he heard, he remembered everything. That is by the special blessing by Baladeva. And because he could remember it, he has delivered as it is. He has delivered as it is to all Chaunakas. So from this we can understand that Baladeva, because of Balarama's blessing, the Bhagavatam has again. Otherwise, that has happened at the end of Dwapara Yuga, and Suta Goswami started narrating in the Kali Yuga time. So we can say that we should be very grateful to Baladeva and Balaram for giving this Bhagavatam to us through Suta Goswami. So Suta Goswami remembers this, and we also should remember and glorify Baladeva and Balaram, so that by our gratitude we become attached to Srimad Bhagavatam. So this brings to the conclusion of the first story, the glories, the mystical power of Baladev, the unlimited, inconceivable power of Baladev.